What if we told you the biggest snake that ever lived was as long as a school bus, as heavy as a car, and capable of swallowing a crocodile whole? Welcome to Amazing World Facts. Today we're diving deep into the world of Titanoboa, the largest snake species ever recorded in the history of our planet. This colossal creature ruled the Earth long before humans appeared, and its story is as thrilling as it is terrifying. So grab your explorer's hat and join us on an epic journey into a time when monsters weren't myths, they were real. Our story begins not in a jungle or a dark cave, but in a coal mine in Cerrejón, Colombia, in the early 2000s. As miners excavated deep layers of earth, they stumbled upon fossilized plants and animals dating back to the Paleocene epoch, roughly 60 million years ago, just 6 million years after the dinosaurs went extinct. Among the incredible finds were vertebrae and rib bones so massive that scientists at first assumed they belonged to a crocodile or even an ancient marine reptile. But upon closer inspection, herpetologist Dr. Jason Head and his team made a shocking realization. These bones belonged to a snake unlike anything the world had ever seen. They had discovered Titanoboa cerrejensis, literally meaning Titanic boa from Cerrejón. So just how big was this prehistoric serpent? Let's break down the numbers. Length, up to 42 to 47 feet, 13 to 14.5 meters. Weight, estimated to 2,500 pounds, over 1,700 kilograms. Girth, as thick as an oil drum, nearly 3 feet wide. That's longer than a Tyrannosaurus rex, heavier than a polar bear, and thicker than most humans are tall. To put it in perspective, the largest living snake today, the green anaconda, can grow up to 20 to 30 feet and weigh around 500 pounds. Titanoboa was more than twice its length and five times the weight. Imagine encountering that in the wild. To understand how such a monstrous snake could exist, we have to look at the world it lived in. The Paleocene epoch was a time of tropical heat, dense jungles, and rapidly evolving ecosystems. With dinosaurs gone, new creatures were taking their place. Massive turtles, giant crocodiles, and early mammals roamed the lush forests of South America. The Cerrejón Formation, where Titanoboa was discovered, was once a swampy jungle, similar to the Amazon rainforest, but even hotter and more humid. Scientists believe the average temperature in Titanoboa's habitat was around 90 degrees Celsius or higher year-round. That matters because snakes are ectothermic. They rely on external heat to regulate their body temperature. The warmer climate allowed Titanoboa to grow bigger and longer than any snake could today. Now that we know how big Titanoboa was, a burning question arises. What did it eat? The answer, whatever it wanted. Titanoboa was an apex predator, meaning it sat at the very top of the food chain. Its primary prey likely included large turtles, like Carbonemys, which could grow as big as a car tire, ancient crocodilians, including 12-foot-long dinosaurs, possibly even early mammals and large fish. Like modern constrictors, Titanoboa didn't use venom. It would wrap its powerful coils around its prey and crush it to death with enormous pressure, estimated at over 400 pounds per square inch. That's enough to break bones and stop hearts in seconds. Once subdued, the snake could open its flexible jaw to swallow prey whole, thanks to double-hinged jaws and stretchy ligaments, traits shared with its modern relatives. Given its massive size, Titanoboa wasn't a quick hunter on land. But in water, that's a different story. Paleontologists believe Titanoboa spent much of its time in or near water, like today's anacondas. Its long, muscular body made it a powerful swimmer, and murky rivers offered the perfect cover for ambush attacks. It likely lay in wait near riverbanks or shallow pools, silently gliding through the water. Then, in a flash, it would lunge, coil around its target, and begin the crushing embrace of death. Because of its sheer mass, it probably couldn't chase prey for long distances. Titanoboa relied on stealth, patience, and brute force to secure its meals. Titanoboa was a buoyed snake, part of the same family as modern boas and anacondas. It shares many features with its living cousins, including body structure, hunting style, and skeletal features. But while boas today are large, Titanoboa is in a league of its own. The fossil record suggests it evolved after the extinction of the dinosaurs, taking advantage of an environment rich with prey and free of large terrestrial predators. Over time, as climates cooled and ecosystems changed, such massive snakes could no longer thrive, paving the way for the smaller constrictors we see today. Titanoboa's terrifying size and mystery have made it a favorite in pop culture and documentaries. In 2012, the Smithsonian Channel released a stunning documentary titled Titanoboa, Monster Snake, using CGI to bring the prehistoric serpent to life. The documentary featured scientists from the Discovery team and was widely acclaimed for its dramatic recreation. Titanoboa has also appeared in various video games, books, and TV shows, often portrayed as a villainous monster lurking in ancient jungles. But unlike the fictional snakes in movies like Anaconda or Snakes on a Plane, Titanoboa was very real, and it didn't need exaggeration to inspire awe. It's a chilling thought. Could a Titanoboa-like snake exist in the world today? Short answer, unlikely, but not impossible. Our modern climate isn't warm enough to support a snake of Titanoboa's size. As cold-blooded animals, reptiles grow larger in warmer environments. With global temperatures cooler now than during the Paleocene, the natural conditions that allowed Titanoboa to thrive simply don't exist anymore. However, some cryptozoologists claim sightings of giant snakes deep in the Amazon or Congo Basin. Most of these stories remain unverified, but they fuel the imagination. And who knows? In the unexplored depths of Earth's jungles, maybe something extraordinary still slithers in the shadows. Titanoboa may be extinct, but its legacy lives on in science, education, and popular culture. Its discovery reshaped our understanding of reptilian evolution and prehistoric ecosystems. It revealed just how little we know about the creatures that once ruled Earth and how much more there is to learn. Today, full-scale models of Titanoboa are displayed in museums like the Smithsonian National Museum of Natural History, drawing in crowds with their jaw-dropping size and realism. Titanoboa reminds us that nature's monsters weren't myths, they were real. And sometimes, the truth is far more fascinating than fiction. From the steaming swamps of prehistoric Colombia to the hallowed halls of modern museums, Titanoboa continues to awe and inspire. It wasn't just the biggest snake ever. It was a symbol of Earth's wild and unpredictable past, a past filled with creatures beyond our wildest dreams. Thanks for watching Amazing World Facts. If you enjoyed this journey into the prehistoric world of Titanoboa, don't forget to like, subscribe, click the bell icon so you never miss a bite of fascinating history. Got a theory about Titanoboa or a favorite prehistoric animal? Drop it in the comments. We love hearing from fellow explorers. Until next time, keep wondering, because the world is more amazing than you ever imagined.